We are beginning on the school watch. Students, teachers, and parents are pleading with the public to help with old and rundown schools. Measure P is on this year's November 2nd ballot. It would raise over $100 million to improve and upgrade Monterey Peninsula Unified Schools. It is a district that lost $36 million in state budget cuts in the past year. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Monterey with all the details.
Aaron, get this. One Monterey High classroom has 50 computers stored away because the room itself only has 3 electrical outlets. Now, this is the kind of problem that these schools are dealing with, and many are banking on Measure P to fix things.
We're doing...
To know how bad the classrooms are, just ask these Monterey High freshmen.
I, like, sit right next to the door, and it's hard for me to concentrate because it's, like, really cold in the morning. And then sometimes in Spanish... I have it next, and, like, it's really hot.
It affects us because, like, it's too hot, and you're concentrating on keeping cool or keeping warm and can't focus on your work.
The out-of-whack classroom temperatures aren't surprising, considering Monterey Peninsula Unified Schools are fairly old.
We have facilities here, Stephanie, that were built in 1922, and our newest facility is 1971, and they've been neglected.
That's where Measure P comes in. If voters approve the bond this November, residents would pay $30 for every $100,000 of assessed property value. On average, about $90 per household a year.
Even a million-dollar home, that's only a dollar, less than a dollar a day to support the children.
There's 2 facilities master plan.
Tuesday night, district leaders went to the Monterey City Council to present their facilities master plan. It's a list of upgrades that would help every MPUSD school, mostly in heating, plumbing, and essential repairs. They say the $110 million Measure P would bring is more critical after the state's recent education cuts.
Being able to survive, and we've done very well. However, that means our facilities have gone untouched.
For those who don't have kids in the district and don't want to give up any more money in difficult times, these students say they're a good investment.
You're talking about young kids learning.
Not only will it keep us, like, healthier and stuff, but it'll raise our grades because we can concentrate more and do better.
Now, committee members pushing Measure P say of the 10,000 people they've spoken with so far, the majority support the measure. That the few that are concerned say they just want to make sure they know where their money is going. And they may find some comfort in knowing that an oversight committee will be formed to audit the yearly spending. Aaron.
All right, Stephanie, thank you. Measure P has plenty of support. Seaside City Council members are expected to pass a resolution at Thursday's meeting endorsing the measure, something Marina has already done. It does, however, need 55% of the votes on November 2nd to pass.